He is football's ultimate journeyman. Lutz Pfannenstiel has played for 25 clubs in 13 countries. He's the only footballer to have played in all six FIFA confederations. It's here, in his Bavarian hometown, in the south of Germany, where the story began. As goalkeeper, he played for Germany's under-17 national team. When he received an offer to play for Bayern Munich, he rejected it.
For me, it was never about money, or it was never about being a famous footballer. And the travelling was one of these things where I said, well, I don't really care where it is. I also would play in Mongolia, or I would play in Madagascar, or I even would play in the moon. I just wanted to play football.
Lutz opted for teams he knew were going to give him regular game time. Being second choice at a big club wasn't an option.
Sitting on the bench was, for me, actually the biggest nightmare I could imagine as a professional. So that's why, whenever I was not 100% sure if I can make it in the first team, I started to look for clubs. And that's why I had quite many transfers well in my career.
In 1993, he took off from Munich to go to Penang, Malaysia, his first international stint. And on he went to clubs in Europe, Oceania, Asia, North America, South America, and Africa. He's played in over 500 stadiums worldwide. But it was never just about the game. As a world traveller, he loves to explore new cultures and habitats.
For me, it became more like an addiction to start moving around. You know, the culture, the animals, the languages, the food, all these things I always wanted to experience. It was, for me, not good enough to be a football player.
The most traumatic episode of his career took place during a spell in Singapore, when he was accused of match-fixing. He spent 101 days in one of the world's most notorious jails.
You have no bed, you have no toilet, just a hole. You have no toilet paper. The second thing was that you're spending your time with hardcore criminals. You know, in my cell there was rapists, there was murderers. And, well, I was put in there because the judge told me I played too good.
Pfannenstiel managed to clear his name and was released. Soon after, he found himself in another critical situation, fighting for his life. In a match for Bradford Park Avenue in England, he collided with a teammate and was declared dead on the pitch, only to be successfully resuscitated.
There was no more pulse, there was no more heartbeat, and I basically died. I always say in Singapore my brain was dead, now in Bradford my body was dead.
The journeyman overcame his near-death experience by doing what he loved most, moving clubs and travelling the world. Pfannenstiel retired in 2011, but he's still in the game today. As a scout for German Bundesliga side Hoffenheim, he scours the planet looking for talented players. He also works as a TV commentator, and he's written a book about his journey.
I mean, I played in 25 clubs. I played all over the world. I got to know all the football cultures. To gain this knowledge, gain this experience, it gave me a very, very unique position now in the world of professional football, because I know the chairman of a club in Argentina, I know the president of the football association of Mali, I have friends all over the world. So if I need an information, I need to know something about a player, you just give me a name and I can tell you what the guy likes for dinner every Saturday evening.
Meanwhile, Hollywood has been in touch to try and secure the rights to this Globetrotter's story. Although he hasn't won any titles or trophies, there will be plenty of episodes to tell from the life of a rather unique footballer. Alex Thomas, CNN World Sports.